Hey, what's up, everybody? It's Keem Stream here, and in today's topic, I wanted to talk about the first half of Season 8 of The Walking Dead. Just give a little recap on it and some of the key points and things that happened throughout the first half of this season. So, let's just dive on in. Now, already, you know, this first half of this season has a lot. I mean, it has a lot of memorable moments. Like, it's just so crazy how this season played out, and it was so fast-paced, and you know, one thing that's a good thing about that is, you know, season 7 had the build up to this season, and now we finally get this all out war season. You know, I'm loving it so far, but then again, it does have a lot of sad, memorable moments too, so let's discuss those. So, you know, first off, we see, you know, the group, of course, you know, being destructive as usual when they go after somebody, and, you know, the main antagonist, of course, they, you know, of course, messed up Negan's meeting and things like that, and, you know, the war starts, and you get to see the rally, and, you know, King Ezekiel gets his group out there, you know, he's rallying and saying, you know, trust the king, and yet I smile. So, you know, it was just some great moments, you know, with these characters, and then, you know, all of a sudden, you see a turn of events, you know, you see the characters start to be kind of back under the Savior's thumb. You know, more in this season again, you know, not completely, but you do get moments where they are, because, you know, King Ezekiel's a group, you know, the kingdom, they fall to a degree. You know, he loses a lot of, King Ezekiel loses a lot of his men. Rick is, you know, captured. You know, Rick and Daryl hasn't really been seeing eye to eye. You know, Carol hasn't really, you know, Carol has helped, but she hasn't been able to be as effective as she normally can be in this season either. You know, Tara and Rosita are struggling with their, you know, the morality and the morals of the show, you know, the things they've been through in the past, and Morgan, you know, and Jesus and Tara, you know, didn't quite agree on a few things, and, you know, one good thing about Jesus, though, in this season is that, you know, he hasn't completely lost his head either. You know, a lot of people, you know, not, the characters throughout the show, they're kind of angry, but, you know, he's angry too, but he's been able to keep his composure throughout the season so far. Which is a good thing, but then again, you know, after what the Savior's done, you know, it's kind of hard to, you know, discuss what you would do in those situations where you have the ability to either end all the people that have given you, you know, so much crap, you know, for so long, or do you spare those people? You know, it's just a good, you know, debate and a good topic to talk about, you know, because, you know, when it comes to the Walking Dead TV show, you know, we always love discussing these type of things throughout the show. And that's what makes the show what it is today, is, you know, especially things like this, topics and things like that. So moving on, you know, you just see a lot of things, and, you know, Rick is trying to make, you know, try to make a deal with the Trash Pail Kids, as they like to call them, Trash Pail Kids, and, you know, Jadis is being herself, you know, talking about, you know, hooking up with them and stuff like that, and, you know, trying to flirt with them here and there, and trying to, you know, get him to make a bigger deal with her and stuff like that, and pretty much been her, but, you know, she eventually joins, of course, and, you get to see a lot of heroic moments from, Carl, too. You know, Carl hasn't lost his way either. Carl was a, you know, he grew up on the show, you know, he really did grow up on the show when, you know, he became this, you know, really, people really thought he was gonna become the future of the series in general, and sadly, Chandler Riggs, you know, aka Carl, is, he's out of there. He's gone, like, you know, and it's kind of crazy, because you would think, like, Carl is definitely next in line after, you know, it's Rick's time. You know, when we get to that point where it's Rick's time, you definitely would think, like, yeah, Carl is going to be the next, you know, in line, because, you know, previously we already know that, you know, Rick, you know, pretty much said that Shane is the father of Judith, and so technically, you know, he still only has one child, but, you know, Judith is Rick's, you know what I'm saying? He's the father of her, because he's raising her, and he's caring for her, he's fathering her. So, you know, that, you know, Rick is the father of her, but biologically, of course, you know, Carl is, you know, part of, you know, Rick's little, you know, DNA, so, or his heir, I should say. But yeah, so it's just a lot of things that really factor into this going into the second half of the season, and it's gonna be heartbreaking to see him have to, you know, put his son away. Like, that's gonna be so crazy. Like, just imagine if, you know, you, aka the viewers, you know, just imagine if you were in that situation. Now, let me know in the comment section down below what you think about you know, these type of things like that throughout the show and stuff like that. Definitely, we'll love to hear what you guys you know, think about that, and to see what you guys will put and say and all that. So, but as far as the show, man, it's interesting. It's very interesting to see how this is going to play out, you know, especially the future of the show and the characters that we pretty much already know are in the front, you know, like Rick, Daryl, Maggie, you know, Carol, and, you know, King Ezekiel, and, you know, so on, etc. You know, those, just those characters, you know, it's going to be interesting to see, because now if, just say if, you know, next season, I'm speaking hypothetically, I'm not saying this is going to happen, but, you know, just say, like, not if Carl's going, like, that doesn't make anyone safe at this point. I'm just being honest. You know, they went as far as killing, you know, the future of the show, which is Chandler Riggs, aka Carl. They killed him off, and just think about that. Like, that's very important, because, you know, like I said, he was the future of the show. And, you know, Judith is still young, so, you know, it's going to still take her time, take some time for her to age throughout the show. But Carl was, you know, he was young, but he was up there in age too. You know, his late teens, you know, could have been late teens, could have passed for maybe like a 20-year-old maybe. So that was very important. And just think, like, you know, God forbid if this happens, you know, the fans will go crazy. But, you know, just say if, you know, Norman Reedus's character, Daryl Dixon, what if he dies? Or what if, you know, Rick goes? What if Maggie goes? Like, you just don't know at this point, because it's so... You know, I like how they switched it up, but it was just very shocking to see Carl go before anybody at this point. It was really shocking to see that. But I know Chandler Riggs, you know, did say, you know, he was doing other things like music, and, you know, it could open up a lot of more positions for him throughout Hollywood. So that's another thing to factor in. And just to see, like, you know, the Saviors is rally back, and Eugene helping them, and, you know, being a coward that he is, he helps them, and then he pretty much kind of contradicts his decision by helping them, by helping Pastor Gabriel. You know, Pastor Gabriel got sick, and he's trying to get the doctor back to Maggie, so that's another thing we factor in too. But it's pretty interesting, and Dwight finally making that final, you know, stamp on his, you know, betrayal on the Saviors and helping the survivors. Of course, you know, Rick's group, he's helping them now, and he put a stamp on that by shooting down his fellow comrades of the Saviors. And so that's pretty interesting. And Dwight has really become one of my favorite characters too on the show. Morgan is definitely my favorite, number one favorite character. And the second to him would be Daryl. Then third is Rick. Fourth, Maggie. But, you know, Dwight is really starting to become a good, you know, one of my favorites. You know, he really redeemed himself. You know, he can still do more. But of course, you know, it was very, very good how they did a good character arc with him. That was really good. So, yeah. So, you know, once again, about all of this and you know, part one of season 8, you know, guys, let me know what you think down in the comment section down below. And also, before I go, I wanted to talk about the confirmation of Disney buying Fox. That's, if you want to know what I think about that, go check out my last video. I talked about, you know, with you know, Disney, you know, possibly buying Fox and stuff like that. But we pretty much knew it was a done deal. So, watch out, man. X-Men, Fantastic Four, and etc., you know, just coming in to the MCU. It's gonna be crazy. It's gonna be a crazy ride, and it's gonna be a good time to be a comic book fan for sure, you know, like, for definite. you know, stay tuned for that as well. We'll be discussing more about stuff like that too as well, and also some more DC content too as well. And you know, we might finally get, we could, I'm not saying we will, but just, wouldn't it just be awesome to see Wolverine versus the Hulk in a live adaptation of their, you know, hero, you know, epic, you know, just battle, their fight, you know what I'm saying? We've seen the comic book versions, and we also seen it in animations, but what about a live action adaptation of that? You know? So, hey, just think about that. Again, let me know what you think in the comment section down below. Please like, share, and subscribe to the channel, and always remember to keep streaming.